Hey guys, can we trust the DTCC to actually act on our behalf? We covered exactly how the new DTCC rule was put into effect last week on Wednesday, but this was not enough to trigger much of anything on Quadruple Witching Day. So with this counter DD from sent directly to yours truly from a Moon Platoon member and friend of the show, Dominic, with a strong counter DD to what the DTCC rule actually means for all of us. And before they start the counter DD, he wants to make sure that you know that he is not a financial advisor. I am not one either. This is not financial advice, and the necessary part of what you need to do before this video starts is to slam that like button so that more apes just like you know exactly what's going to happen with the DTCC rule. With from a nuanced perspective, we're going to be diving into the real language of the DTCC document and giving you guys both looks on good and bad things that can come out of this. And now, without further ado, that you've hit both like and subscribe, let's get going. Before they start this counter DD, they are a fellow ape who has been riding the GME rocket ship from top to bottom. They're a big believer of what GME can do, both as a company and as a stock. And I can attest that this is him truly writing some DD for us directly. He actually sent it on like 10 plus, 30 plus different Discord messages individually, and then said, or just watch my, or just look at this. So that's why we are looking at this for simplicity's sake. Most of you know, hey, it's Pixel's latest DD on GME regarding the new rule change, which got passed on March 15th. Here's the link if you missed it. When I first read this DD, they were excited because they could potentially benefit apes. However, they took the time to research on their own, read the original document based on DTCC.com. Here's the link to the original text. I'll add it to the description. I encourage everyone to double check the authenticity of every DD before putting money into anything. With all of that out of the way, here's the counter DD. First, this is what Josh said. Hey, it's Pixel. What effect does this rule have? Especially in the current situation, in plain English, hedgies have to report their positions on a monthly basis to DTCC prior to the rule change. This is true, but only partially. The fact is that hedgies have been reporting their activity both daily and monthly. I'm not sure how you could miss this important fact by reading the background section. See below. Now this, as far as I was aware, is that this sense of this contradiction, the hedge funds didn't have to follow the daily activity. So this is true. What the DTCC says is that you have to report on the end of each day and a month end confirmation. And my current assumption is that you could just ignore the daily because this contradicts with the monthly. What does this mean? Well, hedgies had to require to report their daily activity at the end of each day. Now they are no longer required to submit the month-end confirmation. Here's the situation. Think of any other dinner. Think of having dinner at a restaurant. Before paying the bill, you double-check the bill to see if there's any discrepancy. If there's an error in the bill, the guests should let the restaurant know. The DTC is the restaurant, and the hedgies are the guests in this example. What has been the case? The DTC sends a receipt of what they record for the day as to what transactions each hedge fund had made throughout that trading day. The hedge fund checks and confirms the accuracy of that receipt. At the end of the month, the DTC sends a hard copy of the hedgie's activity for that month, and these hedgies have up to 10 days to confirm and submit their official month-end statement to the DTC. All right, so here it is. Participant to reconcile and confirm with DTC its month-end securities positions listed on its DTC monthly statement of positions, monthly position statement. This is just some helpful highlighting to the document you can read yourself. We have been counting on the DTC as well as a new NSCC 801 rule to provide us the support that we need. And now we are checking whether or not DTC actually has the right intentions or even the right regulations in place to help us out. Under the new rule, the hedgies are no longer required to submit their month-end statement. However, they are still required to confirm their activity by the end of each trading day. The proposal would eliminate an outdated requirement that participants perform month-end confirmations as described above. By removing this requirement, participants would have to allocate the time they spend on month-end confirmations to other DTC-related activities as they deem necessary, including performance of daily reconciliations. By removing an obligation that DTC believes in no longer necessary to blah, blah, blah. As a result, the statement from Hayes Pixel is false. right? This is from one DD writer to another. So this is just a friendly amount of peer review. It is false because hedge funds had been and are still required to reconcile their daily activity with the DTC. So what happens now? Well, there is no rule stating that they have to report confirmed previously once a month. Next, this part is purely speculation, and there is no data to back it up. At the moment, they're willing to stand corrected if there's a source that stands otherwise, so I consider this statement as a personal opinion rather than DB. So the DTCC now can now ask them to report confirm the position. So essentially, I think the main point of this counter DD is that Dominix hasn't found why people think that this contradiction makes it so that the DTCC no longer is in conflict with each other. I've heard multiple DDs that specifically state that now that there is no conflict between the monthly and the daily reporting cycles, that this means that there is no way to be able, that this is good for us, right? But Dominix is saying that they haven't found any support of that yet. At this point, they think this invalidates the next speculation, especially this part. Remember, they can ask a report on a daily basis now. Why? Because they think the DTC could do it regardless of this change. However, what I think is not important, what the rule implies is there is nowhere in this proposal to prove a speculation to be the true thus far. Again, what they could do does not mean what they would do. Plus, hedgies have been doing that daily. I'm not saying that they are truthful, nor am I saying that they aren't. I just want to be neutral with the data that I have. All right, and here is where they think that the rule is actually a bad piece of news. So we have here in yellow, the DTC would add to the following text to the overview section. Note, it is the sole responsibility of the participants to perform a daily reconciliation of their activity and positions with the information, reports, and statements provided by the DTC. So it seems like it's their responsibility on a daily basis. DTC shall not be liable for any loss resulting or arising directly or indirectly from mistakes, errors, or omissions related to the information, reports, or statements provided by DTC other than those caused directly by gross negligence or willful misconduct on the part of the DTC. And we've already talked about that, right? We've read through this document and said that, okay, they want to shift the blame to someone else. However, right now, this is more like saying, hey, it's your responsibility to do this, and we're not liable in case something bad happens. Like the restaurant saying, it is the customer's responsibility to not shovel uranium into our restaurant, and if that does happen, we are not responsible for that. This portion of the new rule troubles me. Sure, the DTC is putting a huge legal disclaimer here. It's your responsibility, not ours. If you are lying, it's not our fault. Well, we could argue that this part is a disclaimer. Could the DTC expose their lies? Yes. Would they do it at any given time? Maybe. Would this new rule change anything in that regard? No. If the DTC wants to expose their lies, they could do it without this new rule. That's my point. So too long didn't read. This new rule does not work in our favor. Instead, it is the way that the DTC covers themselves on the legal terms. The hedgies have been confirming and reporting their daily activity to the DTC on a daily basis even before this new rule gets passed. Right now, they're just off the hook from the duty to report the month-end position of the DTC. Again, my DD solely focuses on SRDTC 2021-003. To me, the real good news would be the passing of 801, not this one, and that one has not yet passed. So, what do you guys think? What is exactly the point of this DTC rule? And now that we have some counter DD from a friend of the show, Moon Platoon, MoMonkey, Real Dominix, what is to come next? If that gave you a little bit of insights on exactly the log proceedings of how the stock market works and how some people have purse strings and some people have purse strings to those purse strings like the DTC, exactly how does the relationship work with you being the person that essentially is in this relationship of people providing way more money just by making money on having money? For now, but not for forever. Look at these people, have helped out the show a ton. Thank you to those of you in the Moon Platoon and the Gorillionaire and the Meatball to Space Legend tiers, and I will see you on the moon.